Hello friend, and welcome to part 8 of this how to modify your Xbox One and or PS4 Nitrado server. In this guide, we will strip our expectations of DayZ modding on consoles being even remotely close to PC modding. However, we do have some fun capabilities to help us stretch the imagination. Good job, Bohemia Interactive. You've successfully kept me entertained for another year. Congratulations. Please fix your goddamn game. Before we get started, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications for more advanced tips on how to modify your Nitrado server. Also, check out the Discord link down in the description for a chance to get your private server advertised on my next live stream. Let's get started. Let us commence this guide by following path DayZ_missions, DayZ offline, and select your map CFG spawnable types.xml. Once you're on this page, use the handy dandy find tool by typing Ctrl F on your keyboard simultaneously. On the find tool, type zombies. Here you will have a list of all the zombies on your map. This is divided by loadouts and locations on the map. I highly recommend that you leave all the locations set to default. It's a sad moment when you realize that you just spent 4 hours editing a file, and when you go into your server, it's empty, stripped from loot and sets. Notice that there are two categories for each zombie type, cargo and attachments. Are you with me so far? Smack the like button if you got it. Let's start by editing the meat before the potatoes. Cargo slots tell your server to include certain items as it's randomizing everything. For the sake of the length of this tutorial, I will fully edit one zombie loadout, but you can repeat this process and add other items to their cargo slot. When you see terms such as food, tools, or mix, this is telling your server that it can pick pretty much anything at random. And remember, this is also attached to the chances and the rate of this item spawning in the map, but we'll get to that in a second. Let's be more specific and tell the server exactly what we want. I am going to add a Glock 19 or an M-Lock 91 in in-game nomenclature, but you can add whatever item you want. I can also add additional possibilities by copying and pasting this piece of code and just changing the value to the item that I want to potentially spawn in the zombie loadout. I can also edit the location, but as I said before, it's best to leave this one alone. But don't let me stop you. Tinker away and Godspeed to ya. Now that I have fully edited the cargo pockets for this type of zombie in specific, cause remember, there's tons of zombies that you can edit. Now we can edit the attachments. These are the items that the zombies may be wearing when you find them, such as a backpack, glasses, hats, and other items. I personally leave this section to default, because I don't really care about the attachments that they may be wearing, but if you do, go ahead and tinker away. Now that we feel fully satisfied with our zombie loadouts, let's use our find tool one more time by using Ctrl F on your keyboard. And I will type Glock 19, but you type whatever item you're working
here,
with.
Here, we can control the chances of this item actually spawning into the map.
I did a guide recently that explains this aspect fully. If you need help with this, click on the card on the top right of your screen and learn more. Are we good up to here? Good. You should have subscribed and turned on the notifications by now. Also, remember to smack that like. Let's move on. I'm done editing the chances of this item spawning into the map, I want to increase the rate that this item will spawn into the same map. We can accomplish this by following path DayZ_missions, DayZ offline dot, and select your map DB file types.xml. In this page, I will be able to adjust the rate. So let's use Ctrl Find one more time and type your item. My item is going to be the Glock 19. Now that I found my item on the list, I can fully edit every single aspect from how many will spawn, when they will restock, their lifespan, and other aspects. If you need help understanding this section, click on the card on the top right of your screen. I did a full guide that fully explains this aspect. Once I'm fully satisfied with my tinkering, I will save my changes and start my server. And yes, I did say start my server, because by now on part 8 of this series, you should know that you have to stop your server before working on it. But if you're still at a loss, message me directly on my Discord. The amount of people I've been able to help has truly humbled me.
Thank you, survivors. Let's keep this tinkering going. And as a special treat to all of my fans, I just added brand new merchandise with discounts to the merch store. Check out the links in the description. And support your favorite content creators. Stay sexy.